Begin to pray, Lord, take these anxieties off of me. All right? Start praying. And this is how you build your confidence, is you build your confidence through the Lord, in the Lord. And that way, you don't have to worry about that falling, because the word does not change. I don't care who you are. That word is not going to change to fit your situation. You're going to have to change to fit the word. And so that's a good thing, that you have to come out your comfort zone. You have to face your fears, your anxieties. Don't run from them. Run towards them. And that way, you won't have to worry about you. Once you run towards them and overcome them, when they come back again to visit, you can keep doing the same thing as many times as you need to get rid of it. Because the devil don't give up easy, y'all. He don't give up easy. So believe God that he is your help. Believe him that you are not alone and that you don't have to be afraid of anything. If you want to start that business, start it. Get your butt up and start it. Okay, the second thing is, back to that first thing. He is the strength, your strength, and have faith in God, okay, in believing that you can do it. The second thing is, define your goals. Know your dream and know your vision. Write this stuff down and out where you can understand it. Where if you got to take it to somebody, that they can understand it, that they can interpret it. You know, we have dream interpreters out here that God has given us, just like Daniel. You know, take it to somebody who can interpret what you just wrote down, who can make it clear for you. Define your goals, know your dream, and leave room in your life to live it. You know, too many times we write this stuff out and we don't leave room enough to live it. Leave room in your life to actually live out your dreams and your visions. You have to know, else someone else will sell you their dream and their vision. So leave room in your life to actually live what you just wrote down. The third thing is, be dedicated. Be dedicated and consistent. Don't let setbacks or little hiccups in life prevent you from moving forward. You have to ask yourself, how bad do you want it? How bad do you want it? How bad do you want it? You know, cheerleader mode, I tell it to you three times. How bad do you want it? You know, situations are going to happen. And like I said, there's going to be some bad things that do happen in life. And you're going to have to learn how to have faith in God and keep pushing and don't give up. During my bad times last year in 2018, the whole time, it was hard for me to work. It really was. But I didn't give up because I trusted God. I said, Lord, if you brought me to it, you can bring me through it. Now, I know that sounds cliche, but that is the truth. If he brings you to something, he will bring you through it. Be dedicated. Dedicated to your word, to your study, to your devotions, to your faith in God. Stay dedicated. And when that way, when setbacks come, you're not worried about it because you know that all things work out for the good of those that love the Lord. Let's see, where am I at? The fourth thing is, journal. Record your progress. And when I say record your progress, guess what? You can record your progress before the progress. You can record the beginning phases of it. You know, I love a diary. I love a good diary where I can write in there how I'm feeling, what I'm feeling, what are my thoughts as I'm writing this, you know, about my business. How do I feel about my business? Do I really want to do this? Yes, how excited am I about my business? You know, journal down those things. You know, your success and failures, write it down. Even if you fail at some things that you're trying to do, write it down. All of your progress. It helps to determine your next move. It helps you to understand you a lot better. When you understand you, you can understand how to help others because you have that confidence in you, because you know who you are. You know that you're a child of God. You know things that you like and things that you don't like, you dislike. And by journaling these things down, you know, even down to the foods that you eat. Sometimes you eat foods that may give you a headache. If this is going to interfere with you writing out your business plan, you need to write that down, that these are the foods that I need to stay away from today. If you know that you have issues with high blood pressure, you need to write that down. I need to make sure that I take my medicines today so that I can get through the process of this without having to go to the doctor or having to have an emergency, call the ambulance and stuff. It's so important. Writing is so important. And I can't stress enough how important writing is. It's a blessing to be able to write. Write it down. The fifth thing is live a positive and impactful life. You know, if you can have impact on your life by living positive, you know, it rubs off. It helps you to build your stamina. So whenever the bad happens, because it is going to happen at some point, some things are going to happen, but faith is going to let you know it's all working for your good again. Having a positive attitude can get you through any circumstance. When you have a positive attitude, you don't see the glass as half full. You see it all the way full because you have God now. All right. So those are some of the things, and I hope I have encouraged you spiritually and mentally when it comes down to starting your own business. It's 2020, folks. It's time to get off in your butt and go do what God has given you to do. It's time for you to stop holding back. You are great at what you do. No one can do it like you. That aha moment was not for nothing. It was for something, and you've already been through the worst part of it, which was having to overcome that circumstance, that situation. I don't know. It could be something like a divorce. It could be death in your family. It could be a broken relationship. It could be your children. You've already overcome so many battles. And those battles that you have overcome are what God has, it was preparing you. God ordained you to go through that as part of your preparation for the things that you haven't seen that he's prepared you for. And before I go, I want to leave this encouraging word with you as well. One thing about encouragement that I love is that it helps to build you up. And if you believe that it can be done, I want to encourage you and let you know that it can be done. And it's important to be encouraged by others, and it's important to encourage yourself. Hebrews 3 and 13 reminds us, but encourage one another daily as long as it is called today, so that none of you may be hardened by sin's deceitfulness. Imagine how many people could have by now had their business started for 10 years who now could have been celebrating their happy anniversary for their business, but they kept letting stuff get in the way because they kept getting discouragement from the wrong people. You have to pray for God to put the right people in your path so that we can build one another up, not tear each other down. I'm happy for you. If you're starting a business, even if you do what I do, I'm happy for you because it's enough people out here in this world that you have your set of people to cater to, and I have my set of people that I'm assigned to. And so it's no need to get jealous of one another. It's like you see the restaurants out here, KFC, Bojangles, they're right there side by side. Hardee's, all of them sell chicken. And guess what? They have competition. They're at competition with one another, but they're all still making millions and billions of dollars, you know. So at the same time, and they all have different ingredients. God has given you a different ingredient. Even if it's the same thing that someone else is doing, God has given you a different ingredient to use. Encouragement is necessary in our faith walk because we will have trouble, but we have to take heart in understanding that John 16 and 33 reminds us, but take heart, I have overcome the world. We know the world hates us because we aren't like them. And so therefore, people that are in a worldly mindset, in a worldly lifestyle that is out here constantly sinning and sinning, they're not going to approve of your business. They're not going to want you to start nothing. They're not going to want you to come off the ground because they want you to be like them. It's sad, but sometimes that's our own family members. It's our own coworkers. You know, sometimes you got coworkers that you become friends with. At least you think you're friends. But as soon as you tell them your idea, they find a way to discourage you. But then next thing you know, I got a good example of that. You tell a woman that you're getting ready to wear a certain skirt and blouse, and they tell you, oh, no, I wouldn't wear that. But then the next weekend, they done went out and brought it, and they wearing it. You see what I'm saying? Jealousy is going to happen. It's out here, too. We're always in some type of battle daily. That's why it's important that you get with folks who will encourage you to do better. Get with folks who will teach you if you don't know better. It's times when we don't give up. When you don't give up and you keep going, God will smile on your vision. God will smile on your dream. He will lighten your heart. Encouragement helps us through tough times. And it does help to discipline us. Encouragement gives us the will to carry out God's will for our life. It gives us a glimpse. You know that faith gives us a glimpse of a bigger picture. It helps to prevent us from being burned out. If you want to see the bigger picture, have faith. Start reading scriptures and you will see that bigger picture. All right, so our homework assignment is going to be, I want you to actually write. I love making y'all write. I want you to write the negative things mentally, write the negative things that mentally discourage you. I want you to identify your discouragements. Write down things that discourage you from starting your own business. You need to know these things because if you don't know it, then you can't attack it. So I want you to pray for God to reveal your flaws. Well, not your flaws, but reveal your discouragements, because sometimes we have discouragements and they're deep down inside of us and we don't even realize that we have been discouraged this whole time and don't realize that this is why we can't go, because we lack confidence in a certain area in our life and it holds us back. So when you write down these discouragements, I want you to also write a solution. Find your scripture. I want you to actually find your scripture in the Bible that pertains to your discouragements and encourage yourself in the Lord. That's what I want you to do. I want you to encourage yourself in the Lord, because if there's a business inside of you that's a seed, it can grow. It can grow and it can get really big. And I'm cheering you on. Yes, you can do this. You can do this. Don't let nobody hold you back. You got a cheerleader. If you ain't got near another cheerleader, you got Miss Coco cheering you on to do better, to get out there and start that business. All right, y'all. So I'm at the end of this, and I hope that you truly have got something out of it. I know it's probably exactly what somebody needs, to be honest, because, you know, when it comes down to starting businesses, first thing we think is that we got to have the business idea and all that stuff. But no, the first thing you need to do is be well. You need to be spiritually well and mentally well so that you can write down the things that you need to write down. Y'all, I feel like I'm about to sneeze. Oh, excuse me. And so I hope that the homework assignment helps you to detect the things in your life that have been discouraging you and keeping you from going forward. Imagine that you've been hoarding stuff from your past that has been holding you back. You've been hoarding stuff that people have said over your life back in the days. Y'all know that back in the days when those family members would get together for family reunions and insult one another, oh, you're too big, or where'd you get that dummy from? You know, say stuff like that, you know. You'd be surprised the discouragements that you're holding and hoarding inside of your heart. And I pray right now in the mighty name of Jesus that every discouragement that you are attached to that's inside of your heart, this deep inside of your heart, that it has to rise up and come out in the mighty name of Jesus so that you can be mentally and spiritually well in this season in 2020. To start your own business. In Jesus' name, amen. And y'all, I will see y'all next Wednesday. And I think next Wednesday, we ought to go on and start that business plan. Don't you think? at least go ahead and get some information on how we can start a business plan. Thank y'all so much for listening and joining me on iHeartRadio.